axon from the axon of the sensory neuron, the neurotransmitters gets diffused to the sensor, into that synaptic cleft, and then the message can be transmitted from the sensory neuron to the relay neuron. Okay, this can happen because the shape of the neurotransmitter molecules is complementary to the shape of the receptor molecules. The binding of the neurotransmitter with the receptors triggers a nerve impulse in the relay neuron. This impulse sweeps along the relay neuron until it reaches the next synapse. So then what is the next synapse here? The next synapse here in this particular picture, the next synapse is between the relay neuron and the motor neuron, right?
Yes.
The first synaptic cleft you can see here, that is between the sensory neuron and relay neuron. This is the first synaptic cleft you can see in this particular picture. And the next synaptic cleft is here between the relay neuron and the motor neuron, this part, this gap. And synapse, the next synapse is this ending part of the relay neuron and the ending part of the motor neuron along with this synaptic cleft. This is the next synapse here. So the message will pass to the next synaptic cleft or next synapse. Synapses act like one-way valves. There is only neurotransmitter on one side of the synapse, so the impulse can only go across from that side. Synapses ensure that nerve impulses only travel in one direction. You all know nerve impulses or the electrical impulses that travel through the neurons. They travel only in one direction. You can see here, because their function is fixed. Okay, the sensory neuron will always receive the message. Again and again, I'm telling the same thing because that is very important. You must understand this one. The sensory neuron will always receive the message and it will pass it on to the relay neuron, and then relay neuron will take it to the brain. Brain will analyze it, and then the brain will give order that now what to do, what we will do against this message that we have received. What action should we do? What action should be taken by us? Okay, and that order is again, after analyzing this fact, that order is again given from the brain, again gives this order to the relay neurons, because the relay neurons will carry the electrical impulse or the message from the brain again, and then they will give it to the or pass it to the motor neuron. The motor neuron present in the effector area, in the effectors, effector means the part of our body that will react to the message that we have received, right? So the motor neurons present to the effectors, they will now react. So the motor neurons will receive the message from the relay neurons, and it will give it to the effectors. Now they will react according to the order that it has received from the brain. So this pathway is always follows one direction. There is no chance of the pathway to be in the reverse direction, right? So sensory neuron will always receive it from the receptors, and motor neurons will always express the action, okay, against the message. So the pathway is always in one direction. The impulses always travel in one direction. So here one picture is there. You all know that the sense organs, how many sense organs do we have?
Ma'am, five.
Five. And what are they?
Ma'am, eyes, ears, nose, tongue, skin.
Skin. Okay. So Vishal has told us that five sense organs are there, and he has also told us their names. Now, who else was talking? Who else was talking? Ayan?
Yes, ma'am.
So Ayan, you tell me now, what are the five senses? The sense organs help us to get those senses. So what are those senses?
means water means hearing.
Yes.
And smell.
Smell.
And means from tongue. This is and means from tongue we can taste anything.
Okay. And.
And means from eyes we can see anything.
We can see anything. Skin. Eyes helps. Yes, vision we can say. And last one, skin.
Yes, in skin we can get pain.
Yes, to touch anything, to feel the temperature of anything, and pain for to get the feeling of pain. If we have pain in any part of our body, then we can also feel it by the skin, right? Or if we have any cut or injury on our in any part of our body, then we can feel it through the skin. So the five sense organs are eyes, ears, nose, tongue, and skin. And the senses are vision, hearing, and you all know that ear also helps in the ear, and the front part of our nose that also helps to maintain the balance. So what is that thing that is present there that helps to maintain the balance? Okay, in this picture you can also see the no. Here all the sense organs are senses are written. Okay, you can also see. Now let's read about them. Sense organs, the parts of an organism's body that detect stimuli. The receptors may be specialized cells or just the endings of sensory neurons. In animals, the receptors are often part of sense organs. Your eye, for example, is a sense organ. And the rod or cone cells in retina, you have learned about the cone cells in retina, rod and cone cells in retina, they are the receptors. So eye is the sense organs. What does it do? If you are looking at, I have given you an example also while doing that, while reading that chapter. So suppose you are looking, at a flower, okay, red flower. So now what will the eye do? How you will understand that this is a flower, it's not a leaf?
When the eye is focused on the flower.
The eye will detect or eye will determine that this is a flower? No, eye will just receive the light rays that are reflected from the flowers, okay? So the light rays, when the light ray will fall on the flower and it will reflect back to your eye, to the cornea, then it will just receive the light rays. Okay, it will just receive the light rays that are coming from the flower, that are getting reflected from the flower and coming towards your eye. Now it will pass, it will be passed to the rod and cone cells. When it will be passed to the rod and cone cells in your retina, they will receive it. They will receive the message that this type of light rays has entered the eyes. So I will focus the light rays. Whatever light ray is coming from that flower towards your eye, the eye will focus it and it will pass it to the rod and cone cells present in retina, which will now act as receptors. Why? Because we all know that neurons are connected to the to those rod and cone cells of retina. Those neurons will just take up the message, what we call impulse. They will just take the impulse and carry it to the brain. Now brain will analyze that, yes, this is a flower. This is not a leaf. This is a flower. And the color of the flower is red. And now after analyzing, brain will send again an impulse or message to you that so that you can understand that this is a flower, not a leaf. So our eye cannot detect anything. What it does, it only receives the light rays that are coming from different things around us, that are coming from the door, that are coming from the windows. But our eyes cannot differentiate that this is window and this is door. This job is actually done by our brain. Eye is just focusing the light that are coming from different objects around us. It is focusing it and passing it to the rod and cone cells. Now neurons are connected to the rod and cone cells, and those neurons will take up the impulse and they will carry it to the brain, and brain will then analyze that what is this that you are looking at, what is this object, is this a water bottle, or is this a watch, is this a pencil box, what is this? Your brain will analyze it. Okay, so eye works as a sense organ, and the rod and cone cells present in the retina, they work as the receptors. They receive the message and then they pass it to the neurons, and then neurons carry it to the brain. Okay, is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, rod and cone cells are very, very sensitive to nerve. Rod and cone cells are very sensitive to nerve. This is why you must have seen, very sensitive to light. Okay, rod and cone cells are very sensitive to light. And this is why you must have seen that when there is too much light, you can't see anything. Have you noticed that? When there is too much light, this is why we can't look at the sun properly. Or when there is too much light in any area, we can't see. You cannot look at a very powerful light. Even if you look at it, you will not be able to see anything, right? Because they will not work. Those cells will not just work. Okay, now we will start the structure of an eye. Do one thing, I'm giving you 1 minute time. Whatever we have read up to this sense organ, read once. If any question, any problem is there, you tell me. Here also another picture of synapse is given here, you can see. The axon of sensory neuron, this part. This is the direction of impulse, because sensory neuron will receive it and it will pass it to the relay neuron, right? So the cell body, this is the axon of the sensory neuron. This is the cell body of the neuron, relay neuron. And this is the gap that is called synaptic cleft. So all this part together, they are called the synapses. When the message is, when the message travels from the sensory neuron to the relay neuron, at that time, the neurotransmitters, you can see here, the vesicles, neurotransmitters are actually present inside the vesicles, inside the sensory neuron and inside some vesicles. So when the message passes from the sensory neuron to relay neuron, then in the synaptic cleft, in this gap, these neurotransmitters get diffused from those vesicles or vacuoles. You can see here how these vacuoles just diffuse out the neurotransmitters into the synaptic cleft or the narrow gap. So as the neurotransmitters are diffused out to the synaptic cleft or the gap present between the two neurons, only this is why it is possible to pass on the impulse from one neuron to another. It creates the medium that helps the message or the impulse to travel from one neuron to another. Okay? Here some key definitions are given of sense organs and synapses. Now let's come back to this part. Okay, the structure of the eye. We will not be, as we don't have enough time today, so we will not be able to complete this part. I will just give you one introduction today. In figure 13.10, you can see that the internal structure of the eye, how it looks. Okay, let's see first the figure 13.10, this one. So you can see here, you have also learned it in previous classes, right? In standard 8. In standard 7, 8, you have also learnt it. So this is how the inside, our eye looks from the inside. You can see how many parts are there. The front part that you can see, that is called the cornea. The first layer in front of our eyes, that is the cornea. And then right after the cornea, there are iris. and there is a central gap between these two iris. What is the, if you look carefully, if you just stand in front of the mirror and look carefully, you will see at the center of your eye, there is a very dark part, very dark circle is there, very small but dark circle, right? You must have seen that, or if you haven't seen yet, you just go in front of the mirror and just look at your own eyes. Okay, so you will see that at the center, there is a very dark part that is called pupil. It is present in between the iris, in the middle part of the iris. Now, exactly behind the pupil, there is the lens, which will focus the light. Okay, it will concentrate it, or it will focus it. Okay, and one thing that you must know, okay, this part is called conjunctiva. See, this part, this is called conjunctiva. And have you ever heard about the disease conjunctivitis? Have you heard about this disease, conjunctivitis? Conjunctivitis is actually an eye infection. Okay, that the infection of this part, conjunctiva, is called conjunctivitis. Now look here. So which part is the retina here? You can see this part is retina. And these are the optic nerves. This part is called fovea. Okay. And this outer layer, this part is called sclera. Okay. And here one dark spot is present, which is not clear in this picture. That is called blind spot. Okay. And this internal part is filled with semi-solid vitreous humor, okay? That supports, that gives support to the eyeball. So this is the eyeball you can see here. And which gives support, what gives support to the eyeball? The vitreous humor. It gives the structure and the support to the eyeball. This part is filled with the vitreous humor. It is semi-solid. It is not totally solid. It is semi-solid, a little bit soft part that gives support to the eyeball. So these are some main parts of the human eye. We will read this part in detail tomorrow in the next class. Okay. Now you read this part once again, this whole part that we have learned today, and tell me if any problem is there.